Now we're going to actually install our workshop, which is the Android Studio program. I suggest you watch me so that you can have a sense of what the process looks like, and then follow the text version instructions at your own pace. Also, keep in mind that these are large files. You're going to want to have a strong and stable internet connection. For students with slower and more unreliable internet, you might want to consider finding a wired internet connection. Also, if things are taking a while to load or download and you're getting bored, feel free to go to the next node, which has a quick review quiz game that you can do while Android Studio is downloading. I've created the walkthrough for how to download Android Studio on two different operating systems. I have instructions for Windows and instructions for Mac computers. I'll give you a moment. Go ahead and click on which one applies to you. Okay, I'm going to be installing Android Studio on a Windows machine. Please note that this screencast was done on April 7th, 2015. And I say that just because sometimes the screens or the icons that you might see while installing Android Studio could change depending on what version it is. We're going to give you a text version to go along with this screencast. And since it's easier to change the text version than to go through re-recording an entire screencast, that will be a little bit more up to date than the screencast will. All right, so to start off, go ahead and open a web browser and go to the Android Studio website. It's linked in the instructor notes. You do not have to type this in. All right, so once you've arrived on the site, you should see a big green button that's pretty obvious that says Download Android Studio for Windows. So go ahead and click that. All right, and that's going to take you to the license for Android Studio. You're welcome to go ahead and read that. I'm going to scroll to the bottom, sign my rights away, and then click this Download Android Studio for Windows button. All right, we did want to download this, so we do want to keep it. I'm going to press keep. Okay, and if you look right here, this is a little bit less than a gig of data. And that's about equivalent to downloading a movie file of reasonable quality. So you can judge how long this will take based on your internet connection. Okay, once it's finished downloading, go ahead and double-click the file. We did in fact want to run this, so click run. Yes, we did want to load to make changes. All right, and now we're at the Android Studio setup wizard. This is going to guide you through a collection of screens to set up Android Studio, and pretty much always we're going to just select the defaults. All right, so I'm going to hit next. I want all these boxes checked. Note that this requires 3.8 gigabytes of space, and we only download about a gigabyte. So after this, there's going to be even more downloading. I'm going to hit next. It's a license agreement here. You can go ahead and read it if you'd like. I'm going to go ahead and hit I agree. Oh, yes, I agree more. Okay, I'm all right with all of the standard install locations. All right, gonna say next on the emulator setup. We'll talk about this later. Sure, let's make a start menu folder, and I'm gonna hit install, which will bring me to this screen. Of course, if you like staring at loading bars, feel free. All right, it looks like it completed. I can go ahead and take a look at the show details. And I'm not seeing anything here about huge errors, so that's good. All right, I'm going to go ahead and click next. Okay, so the install looks like it finished. I'm going to click finish. This is the little loading screen for Android Studio when it starts up. Okay, now this is asking if I have some settings from a previous version of Android Studio. And I'm pretty sure that you don't, so you probably want to hit the I don't have a previous version of Android Studio or I don't want to import my settings, and go ahead and hit OK. I'm just going ahead and downloading a few more components for me. Now, once you see this screen, you know that you've got Android Studio up and running. But the real test to see if you did everything correctly will be if you can make your first app using it. All right, so this completes the installation video, and now you're going to do this process on your own. All right, I'm going to download Android Studio on a Mac. Note that this screencast was done April 6, 2015, and the reason I'm saying that is because sometimes this process will change. We will always provide you with text instructions for the install process, and we will keep those instructions up to date. So if things look a little bit different here and there, don't worry, check out the text install instructions. All right, and with that little mini note, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is click the link in the instructor note below to get to the Android Studio homepage. Don't try typing this out, just click the link in the instructor notes. Once you're here, there's going to be a pretty obvious button that says Download Android Studio, and it should say For Mac. Go ahead and click it. At this point, you'll see a license agreement. You can read it if you like, and then go ahead and scroll down, click that you've read it, and then click this Download Android Studio for Mac button. Okay, so it's started downloading here for me. Now you should be able to see that this download is a couple hundred megabytes. Once it's downloaded, go ahead and double click it. You should see this big beautiful screen that says Android Studio. And as with most applications, you're going to go ahead and click Android Studio and drag it into your applications folder. That'll copy over. After you've successfully done that, you can go ahead and double click Android Studio, which will try to actually open Android Studio. You might get a warning about it being downloaded from the web, but we did mean to download this and we did mean to run it, so go ahead and click open. All right, and this little screen should appear to load up the installation process. All right, and here we are at the Welcome Wizard. What follows is going to be a list of screens and licenses, and you pretty much just want to keep the defaults. I'm going to click next. This is a screen asking me where my Java development kit is. Now we just installed that, and it's actually making a guess about where it is. If it isn't guessing, you can click the detect button. And if that isn't working, you can try navigating your file system to go exactly to where you downloaded it. If you're having trouble with this step, it probably means that there were issues with downloading the Java development kit. You might have downloaded the wrong file, or just something might not be configured right. Try going through the instructions again or checking out the troubleshooting documents. Everything seems to be working here, so I'm going to go ahead and click next. Now, we're not doing anything too crazy, so I'm going to choose a standard installation. Here are some of the licenses that I was talking about. Go ahead and click on this first license and say accept. That'll accept all these licenses down here. You'll have to click on the next license set here and also hit accept. And this will let you finish the Android Studio setup wizard. Okay, when I click finish, it's actually going to download a lot of stuff. And what all of this entails is downloading a couple gigs of data, which is sort of a huge amount of stuff to download. So be patient, this might take some time. If you're getting bored of staring at a loading bar, you can go ahead and click to the next video, where we have a little review game to go over some of the stuff we've already learned. If you see this window, go ahead and type in your password. And the candy cane stripes here mean that this is close to done. Awesome, and once you're done, you should see this screen. Hopefully there's a lot of positive language like successfully, installation pass, successfully created. If you see any errors here, it could mean that there are errors with the installation. But things look good, so I'm going to go ahead and click finish. Now once you see this screen, you know that you've got Android Studio up and running, so great job. But the real test is going to be seeing if we did everything correctly enough that we can create our own apps using it. All right, so now you've watched me do the steps once. I want you to go ahead and download Android Studio yourself. If the downloading is taking a while, but you still want to be doing Android stuff, feel free to move on to the next node, where we have a review game to pass the time while things install.